Good morning, everybody. It is both a pleasure and an honor to introduce Senator Leah Vukmir, who has been serving her community for the last 25 years, both as a nurse and also as an elected official. Earning a bachelor's degree, as well as a master's in nursing, she specializes in child development and primary care treatment for children. Senator Vukmir was first elected to the State Assembly 13 years ago. Now in her second term as a state senator from the Wauwatosa area, she plays a major role in healthcare policy. Chairing the Senate Health Care Committee, she has advocated for tort reform on numerous pieces of legislation and has improved our state's healthcare system. Last year, she authored and supported the Physician Apology and Informed Consent Bills, legislation that reduced the need for defensive medicine and allowed physicians to focus on their patients' health. Please welcome Senator Leah Vukmir.
Well, good morning, everyone. How are you today?
Good.
It's great to see a great, large group of people here and that you're taking action on your civic responsibility. It's one of those things that got me on my path into the legislature. But before I talk a little bit about that, I'm very proud to have worked with so many of you in this room, and many who could not be here, on a variety of issues. Tim mentioned a few of them. I'm also very proud to have been a part of the movement for reforming Milwaukee County mental health. The doctor apology bill, informed consent, HIPAA harmonization, charity care, and there are many other issues that I know you're working on that I am very, very excited to partner with you. You know, when I got into the legislature, I never imagined it as I was in the midst of my career as a pediatric nurse practitioner, mostly at St. Mary's Hospital and also Children's Hospital. I never ever anticipated that I would one day take Scott Walker's seat in the state assembly and then 8 years later run for the state senate and then be a part of the historical 4 years that we had thereafter. You know, I was a mom, just going about my job, taking care of my kids and taking care of my patients. And all of a sudden one day, I had a concern about something that was going on in my daughter's classroom. So you're all very smart. You don't need calculators to do math. My daughter's 27. This was in her 4-year-old classroom. I happened to ask the teacher a very, what I thought, and all of you as people who work in the world of research, very basic question. Can you show me the research to support this reading program? It doesn't seem to be working for my daughter and, for that matter, most of the kids in the class. Well, for asking that question, I was sent to the principal's office. And from there, the principal sent me to the superintendent's office. And the next thing I knew, I was writing letters to the editor and I was going to school board meetings. And one thing led to another and I got my political funny bone was tickled and here I am. I came to the Capitol as a mom of the cause and testified at a hearing before the Education Committee. And 10 years later, I was the chair of that committee. So the moral of the story is be careful what questions you ask of the judges in your classroom. Then you get here, and all of a sudden, there's no manual. There's no book that says how to be a legislator. I walked into my office that very first day that we took our oath, and it was pretty empty office, dusty bookshelves. There was a little coloring book for kids on how a bill becomes a law. I confess I did read it. And I thought, what did I just get myself into? What do I know? What do I have to offer? Boy, it didn't take long. The very first issue that came up was an issue in the budget that Governor Doyle had, and he was trying to get rid of graduate medical education. You all know how important graduate medical education is. Most of my colleagues had no idea what graduate medical education is. I knew what graduate medical education is. And that's when the light bulb went off and I said, oh, I guess I do know how to be a legislator. And so my message to you is, I want you to understand what it's gonna be like for you as you talk to my colleagues on both sides of the aisle. We are in many ways, and I will use a medical metaphor that you all will understand. As legislators, we are general practitioners. We have to know an awful lot about a lot of issues because we will be discussing the whole gamut of issues that affect our state. But just as a general practitioner knows, at some point, we need to refer to specialists. We too in the legislature know that at some point, we have to refer to our colleagues who are specialists in the various areas, because we come from all walks of life. So, for example, there is not a dairy farm in the 5th Senate District. I'm not an expert on dairy farming, but we are a dairy state, so as you can imagine, there might be dairy farming issues. So I have to refer to a colleague, an expert, a specialist, who understands those issues to educate me. So I tell you that because it was very eye-opening for me, and it made me realize the important role that I have being somebody in healthcare. And it also is important for you as resources to your legislators, because legislators also look to their constituents and to the special interest groups that have concerns that they bring before the legislature, because you are experts as well. And so it's been a fascinating experience, and in many ways, my colleagues sometimes get a little upset with me because healthcare isn't always a partisan issue, the issues that come before us. And, you know, apart from if you're talking about, you know, macro level issues on how you deliver healthcare, government run versus not, but the day-to-day issues that come before our committee really have to do with basic understanding of what is the role of a nurse practitioner, what is the role of a physician, how do they interact. And so it used to frustrate my colleagues when Dr. Sheldon Wasserman, a former state representative, and I both served on the education committee, and we both served as in the minority and majority. So we were a team. And oftentimes, votes that were coming out of our committee were unanimous on a regular basis. And my friends, both his friends and mine, were saying, how is it that you two are able to do that? And so apart from what you hear in the news all the time, that everybody's fighting up here, on a day-to-day basis, we get an awful lot of things done, and especially in healthcare. And that's where your role is incredibly important. I know that you're headed off to the Capitol today to talk about a variety of issues, and I know workers' comp is all on your agenda, and I was on your side on that issue. I was proud to stand with the providers last time. And I know that many of you come from hospital and provider backgrounds, so we're continuing to work on this issue, and I know that many of you are continuing to work on this issue behind the scenes, and I know that, you know, you've got Mark Raffentin, who is your great lobbyist and resource as well. He's been a great resource to all of us in the legislature. So I remain hopeful that Wisconsin can continue to achieve better results for our employers than the rest of the nation while controlling costs without a fee schedule. I know that you will also be talking about other issues, the APRN bill, the physician compact, and I was glad to hear many of the questions that were asked, because I'm in that process right now of asking questions and trying to decide, is this in the best interests of our state and for our physicians? So I thank you for raising the questions that I heard. And if you have information, concerns about any of these issues moving forward, make sure that you get in touch with me about that. I want to leave you with a couple stories, because you're going to head over to the Capitol this afternoon, and this is really your opportunity to make a difference. And individuals can make a difference. I learned that as a mom of a cause concerned about education issues, and I've learned it being on the other side of the table now as a lawmaker, both effective and ineffective ways of lobbying. And I will tell you that there was a particular bill, and is Mark Raffentin somewhere, he will remember this, that took the medical community completely by surprise, because it seemed so outlandish that nobody ever thought that it was going to make its way through the process. And you were all busy working in your practices. So everyone just thought, this bill's not going anywhere. It was the licensure bill for lay midwives. How many of you remember that issue? And I heard from many of you. But it was one of those sleeper bills that nobody thought was going to go anywhere. The people that were lobbying for the bill did a wonderful job of going into all of the offices, talking to the legislators, making them think that this is, you know, great. Home deliveries, everything is safe. I remember talking about it in my caucus, and my colleagues said to me, well, Leah, why would you not like this bill? You're a nurse. You should appreciate the role of a nurse midwife. And I said, what did you say? You should appreciate the role of a nurse midwife. And I said, but that's not what this bill is about. well, they're midwives, aren't they nurses? And I said, no, they're lay midwives. Well, at this point, a large majority of my colleagues had already been invested on the bill. The bill got through the process. We tried very hard. Senator Judy Robson, Democrat senator, I was in the assembly, both nurses. We tried to stop it. We even tried to get Governor Doyle to veto it. We didn't. But it was one of those cases where, wow, you know, keeping an eye on what happens and making sure that you get engaged early is very, very important. So that was one example. I'll tell you about another one and that I want to leave you with, because I want this to help you not only about medical issues, but there may be something else in your community that is important to you that you want to advocate on behalf of. When I was a mom concerned about educational issues, a group of us came to the Capitol, 10 parents. I had never done anything like this before in my life. I was actually kind of nervous. I put together a one-page sheet, 10 bullet points. I won't bore you with what the issue was, but there was something in the budget that we wanted removed because we thought it would be detrimental to our children's education. And we were not very sophisticated. We didn't realize that it was the joint finance process and that we were supposed to talk to the joint finance committee members first. We just blanketed the Capitol, just as you're going to do today. I handed out 10 sheets of paper to 10 different parents. We split up. We each took a wing. We left at 10 o'clock in the morning and separated, and then we came back at the end of the day at 4, and everyone was buzzing, talking about our experiences. And when I handed the sheet to everybody, I said, here, you may or may not see the legislator. That's okay. Talk to their staff. Don't spend more than 5-10 minutes. Be passionate about your issue, but don't go over the top. And just leave your information, be clear and concise. And so at the end of the day, we all got together and everyone was buzzing, because none of us had ever done this before. And we walked out the door, and I remember turning to one of the other mothers saying, you know what? I don't know how, what the outcome of this will be, but today we advocated on behalf of our kids and we exercised our civic duties and responsibilities. And then I put it out of my mind because I'd worked so hard to prepare everybody for this. 3 days later, I got a phone call, and the phone call was from one of the governor's chiefs of staff, or not the chief of staff, somebody on the governor's staff. It was Governor Tommy Thompson. And he said to me, Leah, I don't know what your parents said, and I don't know what they did when they walked through that Capitol, but that item has been removed from the budget. Oh, and by the way, Governor Thompson's kind of mad about that. And to this day, Governor Thompson always reminds me. He doesn't even remember what the issue was, because I remember when you did that. So I leave you with that, because one person can make a difference, a group of people can make a difference, you can make a difference. So I look forward to hearing from you about the issues that are important to you. We will not always agree on everything, but as Mark knows, the doctors that have come into my office know I'm always honest. I will tell you exactly how I feel. I will not string anyone along. I see that happen sometimes by other legislators. I'm always very honest, but I do enjoy the partnership and the ability to be your voice as somebody in the field of medicine who may not know everything, and I'm, again, I don't have, I need your specialty areas to inform me and be a resource for me as well. So thank you and have a great day today.